In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to perform a goodness of fit test. For this tutorial, I'm going to be using the Starburst dataset from the Rguroo User's Guide repository. If you need assistance loading this dataset, please reference our video, Uploading a Dataset from an Rguroo Repository. Now take a moment and pause the video and consider the problem I've presented in front of you. From the Analytics pane, scroll down to Analysis, and then click on Goodness of Fit. Now in this dialog box, each row of the table shown is slated for a level of a categorical variable. Rguroo allows you the options to fill out this table manually, or if you select the dataset, to choose the categorical variable, and it will autofill the table appropriately. In this tutorial, I'll be showing you two examples where we use both raw data and summary data to fill in this table. Since our example had four color levels, let's add in four rows by clicking the green plus icon four times. Let's fill in these levels and labels from the summary information presented in our problem. Since the question wants to investigate if all colors have the same distribution probability, we will fill in the expected probabilities to each be 25%. An alternative way of entering this would be to type in 1/4. You can also put percentages, as in the number 25 in each cell. Just note that if you put in percentages, all cells must be typed in as a percentage. However, as a default, if the expected probability column is left blank, Rguroo will interpret this as the null hypothesis to be that all levels are equally likely. Performing a goodness of fit test using chi-squared is as easy as clicking a box. By default, Rguroo uses a significant level of 5%, but this can be changed to another value should you see fit. You'll also be provided with a p-value graph associated with these results. You may also perform a goodness of fit test using a simulation method. Moreover, should you need to compute the power of the test at specified probability values, you will type in the values in the last column. Now let's click on the preview icon and see our results. Here Rguroo reiterates the alternative hypothesis and whether the test was significant at the 5% level. If you would like to add in a critical region plot to your report, you can do so in the Test of Hypothesis Methods section by clicking on the Details icon. I'm going to show you this example again, but this time using data that includes frequencies. Going back to the Analytics pane, scroll down to Analysis, and then click on Goodness of Fit again. This time, select the Starburst dataset. The factor dropdown is where you select the factor variable of interest. In this case, we are interested in the color of the starbursts. Now notice, in our dataset, the levels orange, pink, red, and yellow only appear once because we had one row for each color and a column for all their counts. Click on the frequency dropdown and select totals. This will then provide us with the correct observation counts. Now, if you want to add in your own levels to the raw data, Rguroo gives you the ability to do so. Just hit the green plus button again and fill in the level, label, and observation count. On the other hand, if you are interested in removing a factor level from the table, drag the level to the dropped level box. Levels in the dropped level box can be restored by dragging them back up to the main table or deleted permanently by clicking on the red X. Now, if you have raw data where each row represents a single case, you would select the factor variable only and not select on the frequency variable, because Rguroo will tally the counts for you. One last nifty feature in Rguroo is that if the values in the expected probability column do not add up to 1, so for example, I put the expected probabilities of 2, 1, 1, 1, Our guru would interpret this as the orange starbursts to be twice as likely to appear than the other colors. For more information on implementing a goodness of fit test of hypothesis and the various ways to do so, please reference the chapter Goodness of Fit from our user guidebook.